So, shipping charges. Obviously, what do you gotta think about when you're thinking about shipping?
How far are you shipping?
Okay, one, how far?
How fast?
How fast you need it.
How big is it?
How much
is it? How big it is.
The weight.
The weight.
Is it fragile or not?
Okay. If it's fragile or not.
If it's cold.
If it's cold, like, food, right?
Animals.
Okay, if it's an animal. Anything else?
The lids.
Okay.
Or a wizard.
Oh, how it shipped.
What? How it shipped, right? And all that good stuff because of, again, all the things that we kinda said, right? And can I afford to use, a semi or a train? Obviously, if it's coming across the ocean, I have to have either it on a liner or something like that. And so, like Yah said, I gotta kinda put that calculation in how many days and all that, right? But then, what happened during COVID or after COVID?
Release shut down.
Everything was out in the ocean still for days upon days because there wasn't anybody done unloading, right? And so then, what else have we noticed after the COVID is that, what else happened?
Everything
backed up, but then everything was affected basically, right? So not only did our shipping costs go up, but they went up because why?
They need people to do it.
Okay, we gotta find people in the first place. What else?
There's a lot more to do.
Okay, now that we're backed up in the work, so we gotta probably increase our pay to those people because they have to get caught up.
Another cost to get materials probably went up too.
Now the materials are out of this world, right? Because either we're out of materials or we have to bring it from across the ocean.
Gas prices.
And now, what's really bad is the oil and stuff, right? With the war and everything. Okay, so now the gas prices, and you just see that in regular gas, but you think about, you know, the Schusters and KB Transportation and those kind of guys, they're out of this world now. They're getting charged, so they have to raise their rates to get it here, and then that's manipulating the amount of, you know, what they have to charge for anything, right? Basically, I was at Sneaky's this weekend, and I know the gal that owns that place pretty well. So we got to talking, and she said how much, just in the last couple of months, that they had to raise their prices, you know, and luckily, their name is good enough, and their product is good enough that it hasn't really affected them that much. But all of that comes into play, right? You know, chicken wings right now are out of this world. If you actually want to, yeah, they're really expensive.
Are you paying on chickens? Bird food going on or something?
No, I don't know why it is.
This summer it's supposed to be expensive.
Right.
All meat chickens going up.
All meat and
cheese.
Right. Okay, so if you notice here on shipping charges, so we kind of talked about everything right there. Also, here's some other things that you might want to have to think about. Insurance, right? Special handling, meaning, okay, was it perishable? Was it breakable? Right, so you, not only do we have to have some place to put it then, but we have to have maybe somebody to receive it, right? And nowadays we found out that that's not the easiest because we don't have people again. All right, so all that has to be taken into consideration. And then basically, when you talk about how you're gonna pay for it, okay? Do you know what a COD is?
Call of Duty.
Collect
on delivery or cash on delivery, right? So are you gonna get paid when you get delivered? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe it's on an account, right? Maybe it's, you know, through some other situation. And then you have to decide who's gonna pay for the delivery and the pickup. And we'll talk about all that here. So when you go through the US Postal Service, there's a special way of figuring it out. The package has to, if the package weighs less than 70 pounds and not more than 130 inches in length and girth. You know what girth is?
Oh yeah, thickness.
The thickness, right? They're around, okay? So, the girth is the measurement around the package. So, for instance, if a package is 30 inches long,
10 inches wide and 4 inches deep, you need to figure out what your combination of the length and the girth is. All right, so girth is your thickness around it. So you're going to take your inches wide and your inches deep, and obviously you have two sets of them, right? If you're gonna go all the way around like a regular box. So you would have had 10 plus 4 plus 10 plus 4, which gives you 28 inches. You're just gonna measure that. And then your length was how long it was. So if you can get that as a grand total, which in our case was 58 inches, if it's under 30 inches, then the U.S. Postal Service will take it. Otherwise, you gotta find a different means. And that means probably going to UPS or what are the other?
FedEx.
Amazon.
Speedy, Amazon, something like that, right? Okay, so the biggest thing that you need to take going forward is this statement right here. When you start doing your calculations today, a fraction of a pound is always rounded to the next pound. So no matter if you got 14.1, it goes all the way up to 15 pounds. That's really important, okay? All right, so then obviously you look at the table on page 397, and this shows then what you're going to do. So what does it mean by destination zones? Well, obviously anything that's 1 and 2 would probably be in the same state, or probably a neighboring state or a neighboring county, or it's relatively close to whatever your business is. When you get out to the 7s and 8s, then we're going across the country or across the state, maybe in some situations, but it's gonna be a longer drive or a longer process of getting. Okay, so when you do this now, there's a couple different ways that you're gonna do this. They're gonna give you the amount of poundage and then what zone it is, and then you just take those and you apply them with the chart. Down the left-hand side is the poundage. Again, you're gonna round up to the next pound and then across the top. So basically, you're just gonna use the, it's pretty straightforward, but you would use the amount, and then once you figure out the amount, you do what with it? You go back and you multiply it by the pounds. That makes sense? So let's look at letter A. Now, obviously, there's other things that are involved in the problems, but you first have to figure out how much they're going to charge you per package, and then if there's anything extra. So the extra things would be like insurance, or if it was a weekend deal, or a holiday deal, meaning that you might have to pay extra if it was over that. Okay? So in letter A, it says, Tosco ships 3 packages weighing 5.5, 12, and 15 pounds to zone 3 using National Shipping's 2-day service. Okay, so we're gonna go back and use that. Insurance costs were $31.89. Since the second day falls on Saturday, $15 extra per package is charged. What was the total cost of the shipment? So first things first, I'm gonna get charged $15 because it's on the weekend, and that was per package, and there was 3 packages, so I automatically have $45. And then my next one was insurance. And this is where you gotta kind of read the direction or read the problem precisely. The $31.89, is that per package or is that the total?
Total.
That's the total. So I only have one $31.89. Now how do I find the rest? So again, notice the first one is 5.5 pounds. So that automatically gets turned to what?
Six.
So take 6 pounds and what destination? Zone 3, right? So what is 6 in zone 3?
1175.
1175 for our first package. Next package?
17.
And the last?
19.
Everybody agree with those three? Yep. So we would add them all together, and that's going to be my grand total.
Obedience.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
In letter B, just let's go over this one because there's a little bit different wordage. Okay, Ridgeway ships and insures 5 packages worth $1,800 each by Speedy Air for same day delivery. Here's where they're trying to trick you. The 5 packages worth $1,800 doesn't really mean anything. The worth $1,800 doesn't really mean anything in this problem. Okay. Speedy Air charged $159 for each package, so what do we do with $159? Times five, right? So we have $159 times five. And then if we read the rest, it says what?
50 cents
for $100 of value of insurance.
Okay, so how do I figure out that part of it?
Well, they insured five packages for $1,800.
So do I have to take $1,800 times five?
No. You take 50 cents times
100 divided by 100.
Take all times.
You take what?
1,800 divided by 100.
So you're going to take your $1,800 divided by $100. So we get what?
18.
That's an easy one, right? And we're going to take that times?
50 cents.
50 cents. So we get? $9. Anybody do this math? 5, 4, 9, 2, 7, 9, 5. Plus how much?
$9.
Do we have anything else? So our grand total is? They don't have that, so what do they do different?
I thought you don't have
to. You would take 795 divided by 100. Or do you have to?
Let's go back to this one right here.
That's the insurance.
It's every $100, so wouldn't you just do 700?
Yeah.
I mean, 7 times 50 cents?
No, but see where it says it's $100 of value for insurance per $100. So they did it for a grand total of 1,800. So that's where I'm doing the 1,800 divided by 100. But for whatever reason, they did this times five. They took the 9 times five in this case.
Would that be for $9 for each package?
For each package, yeah. So when this was for the grand total, but then when you figure out the second part, you gotta do 9 times the 5 packages. So now we get 795 plus, this gets us 45, right? So if we add the 2, we get what?
840.
$840. So just a little different, I guess, wordage in that second one. Okay?
Some tricky wordage.
The second part then, they talk about freight. So when we talk about freight, we're probably thinking more of a what?
Big.
Big, right? So this is probably on a what?
Train, ship, truck.
Ship, train, maybe a semi, right? Like a combine or something, if they had to bring that to town or something. Okay, so freight is anything heavy or bulky. The most important part of this, obviously there's another chart on page 398, but the most important part of this is when you see FOB in the problem, that's free on board, the FOB tells you who's gonna pay for the shipping. So when they start writing their problem, if you look at, go over to D, it says, by freight to Carlson Forging Corporation of Toledo, and then it says FOB Toledo. All right? Here's the key to this right here. When it says FOB whatever, the person or the place that is with FOB doesn't pay the shipping. So it's the other company. So when it says FOB whatever, you look at the other company and they have to pay the shipping.
So in D, Maryland pays for
it. Right. In D, we're going back to Mayfield or whatever, right? Yeah, Mayfield instead of Toledo. Okay? Now, here's the next part. So look at the difference between C and D. Well, in C it says Gomez Brothers ships 2 850-pound packages to Zone 4 by Curry Freight in 3 days. What is the freight charge? So to me, this one's a little easier because you're gonna just take that and take it to their direct shipping chart. In some situations, the chart will just be a kind of a ordinary, everyday one where it's applied to like a state. Some companies will have their own, like this company did.
So this Curry Freight had their own little shipping chart. Okay, so in the first one in letter C, it says ships to 850 pounds. I'm gonna take my 850 pounds, so it falls into what section? The second one, right? And we go across to zone four, and so they're gonna charge us what? $1.07, basically. And so then I'm gonna take $1.07 times 850 and then multiply it by two because there's two of them. That makes sense? Now in the second one, in D, it gets a little bit more complicated because they also involve this right here. Shipping charges for weight are done another way, and this way is using 100 pounds as the basis. So if they ask you to use it, and I believe this one does in this one, see where it talks about in the like second full sentence, the freight company charges $19.45 CWT. CWT is something called a hundredweight, okay? So it's just a special way of figuring out, this would be for really, really ginormous things. So if you notice this one, it was worth, or it was 42,000 pounds. Okay, so when you're talking about a hundredweight, you're gonna do exactly what Evan said. You're gonna take that, whatever your total is, and divide it by 100. But the first thing that you have to do, look at this again. This is another big thing. You always have to round up to the next full 100 pound mark. So in this case right here, when we do 42,350, my nearest 100 pound mark is what? 42,400. So you're gonna take 42,400 and you're gonna divide that by 100. Okay, so you're going to, because again it says CWT, anytime you see that CWT, you're going to divide by 100. So again, this is easy because you're just crossing off zeros. But now I would take my 424 times and then whatever they charged for me. Okay, so what did you say? 1945, perfect. So I take that times 1945. So again, you gotta make sure that you round here. That's important. And then this should be your grand total at the end.
8,246.80.
So again, this is where some people get confused. You round the pounds, but you can get a decimal answer. And then, we already kind of said this, but because they said FOB Toledo, who has to pay for the shipping? Then we go back and we do Mayfield. Okay? So they got to pay $8,246 worth of shipping. Now our $10 charge or $4 charge doesn't sound so bad, right?
But if you spend an extra $10,
you get the shipping. So then you have to buy a whole other one though, right? So, yeah, free shipping here is a big deal. You know, going back to just little things around here, when we had to replace the backboard was $275 to get here. Yeah, for shipping. Okay? They didn't talk about buying another one to get
free shipping. They didn't offer a buy one, get free shipping, or
no.
Buy another one, get free shipping?
They didn't have that as a thing. But that's where we're at right now. You don't think that that's a big deal, you know, but that's what it was. So, a couple of kind of weird nuances. You gotta make sure that you round up for your pound, and then you round up for your pound here again, and then divide by 100, if it says CWT. If it doesn't say CWT in freight, then you just take your whole freight to the chart, like you did in the other section, okay? Questions there? All right. So, will you spin that so they get the assignment, please? Mm-hmm.